Hello, welcome to the Monday, May 11th, 2020 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Well, we got a new version of Yara version 4. Now, Yara is the language that's developed by VirusTotal in order to essentially sort of write simple signatures to find files, kind of like an open source antivirus language. And in version 4, we now have the ability to match Base64 strings. The main result here is that it's easier to write rules that contain Base64 encoded strings. Of course, in the prior version of Yara, you could just do the encoding yourself and then essentially match the resulting ASCII string. And in case you wonder, the acronym Yara just stands for yet another ridiculous acronym, or Yara, another recursive acronym. And one thing I have talked about in the last couple of weeks is the vulnerability in SaltStack. Well, we now got a patch from VMware in their vRealize product that apparently does integrate with SaltStack. So they had to fix this vulnerability as well. Two actual vulnerabilities. One is the critical authentication bypass vulnerability, and then a directory traversal vulnerability that affect this vRealize product. And if you're using a Samsung Android phone, you probably want to pay attention to the May update for Android that was released by Samsung. Now, in Android, images are parsed by the SCIA library, but manufacturers of Android devices have the ability to add their own image types to that library, and that's exactly what Samsung did here. These image formats seem to be a little bit Samsung specials. The author of the vulnerability notice had issues finding sort of valid samples for these image formats, but that didn't prevent the author to actually create then some images of their own, which were then used to essentially fuzz this library, and that's where they found these vulnerabilities. Again, the problem here is that there is no user interaction required in order to trigger remote code execution. An attacker would, for example, send you an image that's malformed as an MMS message, or get you to open it either via a web browser, email, or any other methods. And while I believe the author only looked at more recent Samsung devices, this vulnerability apparently can be found in the Samsung version of the messaging app going back to 2015. And well, we keep telling our users, hey, use two-factor authentication. In order to do so, you typically need an application like Google Authenticator or such to create those one-time passwords. But not all of these applications are created equal. Turns out that what appear to be, according to Malwarebytes, a hacker group associated with North Korea has replaced one of these one-time password generating application that's popular among Mac users in China. They named it Tinka OTP, but it appears to be a variant of the open source Mina OTP application. Now, Mina OTP on GitHub is not affected by this. This was something that apparently was then downloaded, modified, and well, enriched with additional malicious components. The application gains persistence by adding itself as a launch daemon and launch agent, so it actually tries to run as administrator as well as the local user, and then it is able to load additional modules, but appears the main purpose of this application is an information stealer and sort of one of those remote access tools. Originally, the malicious application was submitted to VirusTotal by a user from Hong Kong in April. Now, back then, it was not at all recognized, but now most antivirus engines on VirusTotal will recognize it as malicious. Well, and that's it for today. Made some changes a little bit to the layout of the front page of the Storm Center today. So if you run into any issues, please let me know. Also fix some issues that I introduced with the last update. But in general, we are trying to add a little bit more sort of video content, in particular to get ready for Sans Fire, which will happen about a month from today. So if you're interested in that, also check out the page at sans.org with more details about Sans Fire. That's it for today. Thanks for listening and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.